Welcome to this new tutorial. We do something very simple now. How to create a ZBC account. This is necessary to later install a node, make this account the owner of the node. So follow me. Simply go to your browser and you can go to zbc.one. Once you go to zbc.one, you will notice the connection is not secure. This is because our web wallet doesn't connect to a centralized server, because there will be a central point of failure in serving the wallet. But the wallet itself connects peer-to-peer with the peers of the network, and this is done with the direct connection to the IP addresses of the peer. If this website was secured by a secure layer, had a certificate and HTTPS connection, it wouldn't be allowed to connect directly with the IP addresses of the nodes. This is why this website is served in HTTP and not HTTPS. All right, this said, let's move on and create a new wallet. There is a nice button here, it says create new wallet. We press this button, and it's important to understand that the seed phrase that is going to be generated, this is generated client side on the wallet, not server side, is the only things that allow you to access your funds, access your wallet and send instructions. So it's very important that you don't lose it and you don't share it with anybody else. Say, I understand. Here he explains there are 24 random generated words, and these words are going to be your key to create your accounts. These are the words that are being generated for me now. You can choose different languages. If it's easy for you to go in Italian, for example, then you can see them in Italian, French, and so on and so forth, okay? We do English. We copy these words, which means then we then go in a secure text editor and we paste here the words. We see that the copying give us two different formats. One, there is a number for each word, and one is a string with all the words together. So at this point, we go back to our browser. We says, I have written save my seed phrase. So you guarantee that you made a save a copy, write them by hand in a piece of paper, make 2-3 copies, saving your safe in your wallet, do something that make sure you don't lose them. And if somebody find them, they don't know how to use them. You approve the term use and privacy policy, and you click and you wrote it down. But because we don't really trust people in this, there is to enter two words, number 11 and number 23. So we go back here, we see that number 11 is disagree. So we can copy disagree. We go here and we paste it. And then for number 23, we see that is smart. So we go back and we enter smart. At this point, we have demonstrated that we saved the seed phrase properly, and we press to create the wallet. There is the need to create a PIN. This PIN is a short way to just approve transaction without making mistakes. So it wants you to really wants to do the transaction that you're doing. This PIN is also locally saved. It's not related to the seed phrase. It means that you with your seed phrase, you can restore the wallet somewhere else. I'm gonna show you later how it works. And the PIN is gonna be created a new one. So as PIN, I use 1111111. You better choose a safer one, okay? I set the PIN, he asked me to confirm. At this point, I re-enter 1111 six times, and I confirm the PIN. At this point, my wallet has been created. Disable the autosave password in your browser, and we can see that there are several functions here. Now, if I over here, I can see the full address is a ZBC, whatever. I copy this, okay. I go to my annotation here and I paste it here, okay. This will also be useful later when we install the node. Let's pay attention that if you want to manage your accounts, you can create a new account as well. Can be a multi-signature or normal accounts. We can call it accounts too, and this is gonna create a new account. You see which is the one that is selected when you go back home is the one that is going to be in use, okay? So at this point, we can switch between two accounts. So just for convenience, we can choose the second account as well, copy it, and bring it with us. We're gonna try later to have different accounts in order to send funds between two accounts and do other things. All right, so at this point you have created an account with ZBC Wallet, which is important when setting up the node in our server. And let's show you another couple of things. Later we're gonna add the node admin. Once the node is being installed, we can go back to our wallet and add the node admin. We can connect hardware wallet and other things, but in settings, you can see that you can connect to the main network or the testnet if you want to do experiments. The account, usually better to use different account because people can replicate the transaction, but you can add your own network if you are setting up your own blockchain. You can reveal the seed phrase, and which is obviously protected with the pin and allow you to see all the seed phrase and copy it just in case you lost the one that you had. The other option that you have is to log out. Let's say you log out, okay, you can always log in back with your pin, entering only the 1111. Don't need the seed phrase. But let's say that you have reset the data, means deleted from your browser all the information to recover the accounts that you have. If I reset the data, I am sent out and there is no way to log back in. So how to go back to the same account that you had before? You need to take your phrase here. Okay, so starting from the first word up to the last word, copy it, say restore wallet, go in the first, paste, and open wallet. You generate your pin. Okay, this is the same procedure as when you create a new account. And with the new pin generated, you notice that when you go in, the first account start with SOEW and end with 5F5K. Is this the same that we had before? Because we use the same seed to generate the same accounts. If I was entering a different seed, I would see different accounts. So this is how you restore your accounts. Another thing worth of note is if you go to zubc.net and you're gonna end up in the Block Explorer. You see that you can get the wallet also on Google Play and the App Store. So if you have an Android, you go to Google Play. If you have the App Store, if you have an iPhone, you go to the App Store. Okay. Once you download the application on mobile, you will be able to also, you see, the same procedure in creating the phrase or restoring the phrase. So let's say you have a wallet that is being generated in your web wallet in your browser, but you want the same wallet on your phone, then simply you install, press on restore wallet, enter the 24 word, and you're gonna have the same wallet in two different devices. So once that this is clarified, we know that you have your account. And this is extremely important when setting up the ZBC node, which we're gonna see in the next tutorial. Thank you very much, and keep following the tutorial to become a hacker and developer of ZBC and DECBC blockchain.